So now we have a better understanding of how the air system works in your airbrush. With the exception of four parts, we have completely disassembled this airbrush at this point. Three of those parts have to do with the paint system, which we will cover in the next video, and one of those parts we'll cover here shortly. So now we can look at putting all this back together, and as we do that, we'll look at troubleshooting some of the common issues related to the air system. I like to start with the air valve assembly when I'm reassembling my airbrushes. In all the years that I've been airbrushing, I've never once experienced an issue with the air system in any of my airbrushes that was a result of an internal problem, whether it was with the air valve assembly or the air channel in the body of the airbrush itself. It's just never happened to me. So based on my own experience, I would say it's probably not really necessary for you guys to remove the air valve assembly from your airbrushes. I'm not saying a failure can't happen. Obviously, there's three O-rings involved in the air valve assembly. One of those could fail, which means you would have to pull it out to replace that O-ring. But statistically speaking, based on my own experience, I would say it's pretty unlikely. The exception to that would be for cleaning purposes. About once a year, I will completely dismantle all of my airbrushes and I soak them in a cleaning solution, usually overnight, and then do a thorough cleaning of all my brushes. If you're going to soak your airbrush in a cleaning solution for an extended period of time, I highly recommend that you disassemble the airbrush first. The reason being is that a lot of cleaning solutions, and this includes some of the water-based paint cleaning solutions, can be harmful or even destroy the O-rings. So keep that in mind. The one issue that pertains to the air valve assembly and is relatively common is a sticky trigger. If you release the trigger on your airbrush and the air stays on or it shuts off very slowly, then the trigger on your airbrush is sticking. There's a couple things that can cause this. Remember, there's an O-ring that sits right on top of the air valve assembly. The base of your trigger actually travels through that O-ring. So if you've got a brand new airbrush, or if you've recently replaced that O-ring, there's a good chance that O-ring is just a little bit tight. That's what's causing your trigger to stick. So to fix this, we just need to lubricate that O-ring. The good news is we don't need to remove the O-ring or the valve guide assembly in order to lubricate this O-ring. So let's go ahead and put this thing back together. Now, when it comes to putting this O-ring back in, if you just pick it up and try to drop it down into the body of the airbrush, it may land on its side. It may land like it's supposed to go. There's a trick I've found that makes this a little bit easier. And again, I just use an old airbrush needle. I'll stick the blunt end through the top of the airbrush body where the trigger goes, through the hole and all the way through. Then take that O-ring and slip it over this needle. That will keep the O-ring in the correct orientation when you slide the valve body into the airbrush body. That O-ring, again, makes it a little bit of a tight fit. So I found another old airbrush needle. Works great for pressing the valve guide body the rest of the way down. Once it's seated, I'll remove that needle, and then we can take the valve itself, drop it into the hole, followed by the spring, which goes over the valve guide, and then we can take our valve guide and the Iwata tool, lining up the notches on the tool, and then you have to kind of find the center so that the air valve goes through the hole in the center of the valve guide, and then screw that in.
and you have to press it in just a little bit because of that spring. And this thing, remember, these are brass threads, guys. You don't want to crank down on this. I turn it until it stops and I'm done.
When it comes to what you use to lubricate that O-ring, there's a couple choices. There are spray gun lubes or airbrush lubes available. The only one that I don't recommend that you use is the original Iwata Super Lube. It's a blue-colored liquid that comes in a clear tube. That stuff gums up after a couple days, and you'll have a sticky trigger again. They do have a newer formulation that is not supposed to gum up anymore. I believe it's just a clear liquid versus the blue. I've never tried it, so I can't tell you whether it actually gums up or not. Personally, I prefer to use beeswax. And the reason why is spray gun lube and airbrush lubes are very thin liquids. They run down and it'll last a few days to a week, but eventually it's going to run off. The beeswax does not run off. It stays put where I put it. So that's why I prefer to use beeswax. To apply the lubrication, if you're going to use a spray gun lube or an airbrush lubricant, here's what I don't recommend. I don't recommend you open the cap and try to drop the lubrication through the trigger opening on the top of the airbrush. The reason being is there's a gap between the top of the airbrush body and the bottom of the airbrush body. So you'll probably get a little bit of lubrication to fall down in that hole, but more often than not, you're going to wind up with more of the lubrication in the airbrush body itself, which isn't going to do you any good. If you're going to use the spray gun lube or an airbrush lube, I would apply it to the very base of the trigger, the hinged portion. This is the part that travels through that O-ring. Very small amount is all you need. And then you can reinsert the trigger. For the beeswax, I go back to my trusty old airbrush needle. Using the blunt end, I'll dip it into the beeswax so I get a little bit on the end, and then I can drop that straight down through the airbrush trigger hole, rotate it to make sure I get some of that beeswax on the O-ring, and then remove it. To reinsert the trigger, pay attention. On the bottom of the trigger, there's a cutout or a relief that goes to the back. So you gotta aim for that hole and just drop it down. And the reason that relief is there on the back is so that when you pull the trigger all the way back, see, it actually touches the airbrush body there. That's why that relief is there. Now we can reinstall the needle chuck guide, the spring guide, and the needle chuck. If you look at the needle chuck guide, you'll notice this piece here rotates. And if you look at the top of the front of it, you can see that the chrome has been worn away. That's because the top of this portion of the needle chuck guide actually rides against the back side of the trigger. And on the back side, you can also see that the chrome has been worn away where it rides against the guide itself. So as you rock the trigger back and forth, this is rotating. I like to use a little bit of lubricant on the front and the back of this piece just because it gives you a smoother trigger pull. And again, I like to use the beeswax rather than a airbrush lube or a spray gun lubricant, because again, the spray gun and the airbrush lubricants are very thin and they'll tend to run off and they don't last as long. The beeswax pretty well stays put once I put it on there, and I use the same method as I did for the trigger O-ring. I'll use the back or the blunt end of an old airbrush needle. I'll put a little bit of the beeswax on there and just kind of spread it on. It doesn't take very much. That's good. So to insert the needle chuck guide, you want to make sure that the pronged end is facing upward. And I just go in at a little bit of an angle
Once it gets to the trigger, that's as far as it goes. Insert the spring. And I like to use a little bit of airbrush lube or a spray gun lube just on the threads. Again, it doesn't take very much. And I don't spread that around. It'll get spread as I thread this in. And just a dab for the needle chuck as well.
Before I reinsert the needle in the airbrush, I want to put the front of the airbrush back together. Now, if you remember, air travels through the head cap into the nozzle cap. So air leaks are very common at the front of the airbrush. If you look behind the threads on the body of the airbrush, there's actually an O-ring on here, which is one of the parts that I mentioned at the beginning of this video that we hadn't removed yet. You can take that O-ring off. This O-ring is not generally a good enough air seal, I find. So I'll reinsert that O-ring. And again, I like to use the beeswax on these threads. It doesn't take a lot. And then I will also add a little bit of beeswax to just the outside of the fluid nozzle. And then remember, the fluid nozzle just sets in place in the front of the airbrush, and then we can take and thread the head cap back on. The beeswax on those threads should get rid of any air leaks that we might have. Now, when you tighten down the head cap, be very, very careful. Using the wrench that came with the airbrush, you want to tighten it up, but just snug. You don't want to really crank on that thing, because what will happen if you really crank on this, have another head cap and another fluid nozzle here. If you really crank the head cap down on the airbrush with that wrench, what's going to happen is the fluid nozzle is going to wind up stuck in the head cap next time you pull the head cap off. And it takes a very careful approach to get the fluid nozzle out of the head cap when it's stuck in there like that without destroying the fluid nozzle. So again, I can't emphasize enough that just snug the head cap up. You don't really need to just crank on it. And then before I put the nozzle cap back on, I'll do the same thing. Just dab a little bit of beeswax. On the threads. And then thread it on. Hand tight, that's all you need. And then the needle cap can be reinstalled. And then we can reinsert the needle. I don't use any lube on the needle itself. You can if you want to. I never do. Just insert the needle through the needle chuck. Push it forward. You want a positive stop. You don't want to cram it in there. Be gentle, because with enough force, you can actually damage the fluid nozzle on the airbrush just by putting the needle back in. So just a positive stop, and then tighten up the chuck. And then we can put, our handle back on, and we're ready to airbrush. Now, I just said that air leaks are very common at the front of the airbrush. How do you know if you have an air leak? I have two identical airbrushes here. The top one is the one that we just put back together using the beeswax to seal the threads at the front of the airbrush. The bottom one I've stripped down and completely removed all of the beeswax that I had on that brush to begin with. So if I hook up the top airbrush and spray just plain water, pay attention to how the brush sounds as it sprays. That was very smooth. It sounded just like it's supposed to. Now, if we do the same thing with the brush on the bottom, again, just straight water, pay attention, see if you hear a difference here. Hear that pulsating sound? So that pulsating sound is a telltale sign of an air leak, either around the head cap or the nozzle cap. It can be either one. And if you have a relatively new airbrush, you may not need to use the beeswax to seal the threads up. This is more prevalent or more common with an older airbrush, an airbrush that has been in service for many, many years. I've used both of these airbrushes for 15 to 20 years, maybe even longer. It doesn't hurt to use the beeswax on a new airbrush, but it may not be necessary. Another common issue that I get questions about is bubbles in the airbrush cup. So let's take this just a step farther. I've put some more water in the airbrush cup, and I'm going to loosen the head cap up a little bit more. Watch what happens to the water in the airbrush cup. See the bubbles? Right now I'm just using the air. I haven't pulled back on the trigger to release any of the water yet. So if you're getting bubbles in your airbrush cup, that's another telltale sign that you have an air leak around the head cap normally. So the air leak is slightly worse than it was before. That's why we're now getting a bubble in the airbrush cup when we're activating just the air. So if I loosened up the head cap just a little bit more, now let's see what happens. Again, we're getting bubbles in the airbrush cup. Now if I pull back on the trigger, nothing but bubbles. And there's no water coming out of the airbrush at this point. So that's just a loose head cap. Now obviously those results were pretty exaggerated. I had the head cap pretty loose on that airbrush in order to get those results, but that gives you guys an idea of what to look for if you start to see any of those issues creeping up in one of your airbrushes. Obviously the fix is to take apart the front of the airbrush again and reseal those threads with a beeswax, possibly even replacing the O-ring behind the head cap. But those are the most common issues related to the air system that I get questions about and I see problems with. So I hope you guys got something out of this. Remember to like, subscribe, and share, and I'll see you guys next time.